Grasslands are a very large percentage of the Earth's surface, and they're also very important in overall ecology in terms of the water cycle, especially absorbing rainfall that oftentimes comes in large doses here in North Carolina. If it hits pavement, obviously it runs off and it ends up being a flooding problem somewhere. If it hits overgrazed pasture or cropland that's been tilled, a lot of it will run off and cause flooding problems. But a grassland that's healthy has the ability to absorb a great deal of water during a short time and then release that slowly to the system as it's supposed to be natural part of the water cycle. So that's very important overall for all of us. One of the major breakthroughs in the management of these kinds of pastures is the improvements that have been made in electric fencing technology. So these fences that you see here have an electrical charge on them. It's basically sitting in the wire waiting for an animal to ground it out, and then the electricity will flow through them and into the ground. And so just their knowing that keeps them from touching fences. And so having them in a situation where they are confined to a small area allows us to take some control over what they eat and the impact that they have on the land. And then we can move them on to another spot and keep them off the spot they just grazed, again, using this simple technology. And then that allows that area to rest and recover and for the grass to regrow and create more feed. One thing that's been of great interest in our workshops, and also it's kind of a tool to get people thinking and interested in the topic, is the dung beetle. There's the tunnelers, which are the most important ones, and those dig a tunnel about 12 to 18 inches below the cow pie. They take some feces and bury it down in that bottom of that tunnel, and then they lay their eggs there, and then that's where they the larvae develop. So you can imagine that every dung beetle that's born, there's a tunnel that's left that's about the size of a pencil deep into the soil profile. And so that's what one of the things that helps water infiltration during that heavy thunderstorm that we want to capture. We're in a pasture here next to a small stream that we've been studying for quite some time. This stream was a part of the pasture until about 15 years ago, at which time we fenced it out. We excluded the animals from being able to get into the water. There's been a number of studies that have been done. Some of the things we've learned from that is that it is important to fence the stream, but it's also important to manage the upland, the pasture part, and not let it get overgrazed and short so that you don't have a lot of runoff entering that stream area. Now, this can improve the quality of the water, reduce nutrient loading that might be going down into the rivers, as well as make the farmer much more resilient against drought. The more of that rainfall that's absorbed from that one big thunderstorm during the summer can really help a farmer to live through a 2 or 3 week dry spell that may go after that. So really being able to better harvest and use the water on grassland farms is the long-term benefit.